Hi, I'm Peter Travers, the movie critic for Rolling Stone, and this is the weekend where there are no new movies to review. So you know what happens at this time of year. It's all the movies that opened at the end of the year, hoping that you'll see them so they can win awards. Stupid awards like the Golden Globes. Do you all know how stupid they are? I mean, it's the Hollywood Foreign Press that gives them out. That's less than 90 people no one's ever heard of who work for publications hardly anybody has ever read. And yet we all see in the papers, nominated for 247 Golden Globes. It means nothing, people. It's just an advertising ploy. Everybody just wants to get enough promotion for a movie so they can win the Oscar. And this is the time now where all those 6,000 members of the Academy of Motion Picture Arts and Sciences are deciding who should be nominated for the Academy Awards. I'm gonna be here for them now as a service, and I'm gonna call this piece Oscar, Don't Be Stupid, because you're always so stupid. And I'm saying in the beginning, Oscar, don't be stupid about rock music. If you wanna know what the best score of a movie is in 2007, it was Johnny Greenwood's score for There Will Be Blood. Johnny Greenwood, you know, is the guitarist for Radiohead. And he does this score, which is like an electronic, it's like a sonic kind of boom. And here's a movie that's set in the early 20th century, and yet everything he does with this score is amazing. It's original. Oscar hates original. They would rather nominate every Disneyfied piece of vanilla from Enchanted. They want to ignore this. I'm saying, people, you're going to look like morons. Make sure you nominate Johnny Greenwood for There Will Be Blood. And don't forget Eddie Vedder, Pearl Jam's Eddie Vedder, who wrote four songs for Sean Penn's wonderful Into the Wild. And there's one of those songs guaranteed. That is definitely the best song of the year. You leave it out. I know what you're going to do. You're going to be stupid. Don't be stupid. Another thing you shouldn't be stupid about, comedy. You're always picking inane, absolutely stupid, bland, awful comedies when you even deign to nominate them. This year there was a guy named Judd Apatow. He gave us Knocked Up, he gave us Superbad, definitely two of the best comedies of the year. Watch you. I know that you're not going to want to pick Judd Apatow for writing either one of them, directing them. You're going to forget Seth Rogen and Katherine Heigl, who were in Knocked Up. You're going to forget Michael Cera, who was so wonderful in Superbad, and Christopher Mintz-Plasse, who played McLovin in Superbad. Don't be stupid. I'm telling you, this is great work. These were great movies last year, so do them. What else? Directing. This year, Sidney Lumet, age 83, does this amazing piece of directing, Before the Devil Knows You're Dead, the movie with Philip Seymour Hoffman and Ethan Hawke. Every critic in the world loves this movie. Watch you guys forget it. It was too harsh, it was too violent, you didn't like it for this reason. And let me remind you of something else. In 50 years of making movies, you've never given Sidney Lumet the Academy Award for directing. Sidney Lumet did Network, he did The Verdict, he did Serpico, he did Dog Day Afternoon. You guys give him nothing? Do you want to look like bimbos? Please, when you're filling out that ballot, remember Best Director nomination for Sidney Lumet, Before the Devil Knows You're Dead. The other area is endings. You know, a lot of Academy members have come to me and said, we don't understand No Country for Old Men and how it ends. What does it mean? What does it mean? Atonement. What did it mean when it ended? We had to put the whole movie together again in our heads. We had to think. Thinking is good, Academy members. It's good. Remember those two movies. Don't be stupid. I'll say it one more time. Don't be stupid. I'm Peter Travers.